In this video, I'll show you a few more useful plugins that can help you streamline your workflow in KiCad 9. Let's start with the KeySwitch KiCad Library plugin, which is under Library. This plugin provides a collection of popular keyboard switch footprints that you can easily use in your designs. To view the available footprints, go to Footprint Editor. In the Library column, you'll see a list of available keyboard switches such as Alps Matthias, Cherry MX, and many others. Here are a few examples of the footprints included in this library. To use one of these switches, open the schematic editor. Add a push button or switch component according to your project requirements. Now, assign a footprint from the KeySwitch library to the component you just added. Next, import the footprint into the footprint editor to view and modify it if needed. Finally, here's how it looks in the 3D viewer. The next plugin we'll look at is the KiCad library for Arduino modules. This plugin provides access to more than 20 different Arduino modules that you can easily use in your projects. Once you've installed the plugin, open the schematic editor in KiCad. Click on the Place Symbol option. Now, search for PCM Arduino Library. Click on it to open the library. From the list, select any Arduino module you want to use and add it to your schematic, just like you would add any other component. The great thing about this plugin is that the footprint is already linked to each module, so you don't have to assign it manually. Here's the footprint of the module we just added. And finally, here's how it looks in the 3D viewer. The next plugin we'll look at is the Simple Libraries plugin. This plugin provides a collection of commonly used electronic components, such as different values of resistors and capacitors. Here's a quick look at the list of components included with this plugin. To use this plugin, open the schematic editor in KiCad. Click on the Place Symbol option. Scroll down until you find PCM Libraries. All of these libraries are included as part of the Simple Libraries plugin. The best part is that this plugin provides both the symbol and the footprint, so you don't need to link them manually. The next plugin we'll look at is the Alternate KiCad Library. This plugin is quite similar to the previous one, but it offers a much larger collection with over 36,000 symbols and more than 10,000 footprints. After installing the plugin, open the schematic editor or the footprint editor in KiCad. Just like before, you can find all the available symbols and footprints under the PCM prefix. That's where all the components from the Alternate KiCad Library are listed and ready to use in your projects. The next plugins we'll look at are the color theme plugins for KiCad. These plugins allow you to customize the appearance of your KiCad interface with different color themes. To install the color themes, go to the color theme section in KiCad. Here, you'll find many options, but the two dark themes I personally use are Solarize Dark Theme and the WDark Theme. To change the theme, go to the top menu and click on Preferences. Then select Preferences again from the dropdown. In the Preferences window, click on Schematic Editor, and then go to the Colors tab. Click on the drop-down menu and choose the color profile you want to apply. You can also repeat the same process for the Footprint Editor and the PCB Editor to apply the theme across all sections of KiCad. So here is how it looks. The next plugin we'll look at is the Via Patterns plugin. With this plugin, you can easily generate different types of Via patterns in your PCB design. After installing the plugin, open the PCB editor in KiCad. In this example, we'll connect the pin headers to the IC using vias created with this plugin. To begin, create a via using the normal method. Once the via is created, select the via and click on the Via Patterns plugin. Now, select the type of via design you want to use. Next, choose the number of vias you need in the pattern. Set the track width as per your requirement. Then, enter the spacing you want between each via and click OK. After that, you can adjust the position of the vias using the rotate pop-up and then close the pop-up window. Now move the vias to its required position. As you can see, only one out of the 8 vias is linked. To link the rest of the vias, select one via that isn't connected. Press E on your keyboard to open the via properties. In the window, uncheck the option that says Automatically Update Via Nets. Next, click on the Net drop-down menu and select the pin you want to link to that via. Click OK to confirm. Repeat this process for all the unconnected vias, and finally, complete the routing. The next plugin we'll look at is the Set Hole Diameter plugin. This plugin allows you to change the hole diameter of all the pads on your PCB to a fixed size in just a few clicks. To use this plugin, open the PCB editor in KiCad. Click on the Set Hole Diameter option from the plugin menu. In the pop-up window, enter the hole diameter value you want to apply. Finally, click OK to set the fixed hole diameter for all the pads on your PCB. And that's it for this video. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment, I'll be happy to help. Thanks for watching. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more tutorials.